With all the talk about a mosque they want to build about a block away from here, this is the World Trade Center site. I was here. I was on my way to work. This box was mine. It was buried beneath the rubble of 9/11. It's been sitting in my closet for years. I'm donating it to the 9/11 Museum to do my part to show people what took place here 9 years ago. Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eric.
Eric Bowling. How are you, sir?
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Really nice to meet you.
So here it is. Here's the box.
Wow.
You know, I was there. I worked in 93 in the building when they bombed it the first time.
I was
on my way over, coming over in 2001. This was a safety deposit box that was in Chase, Manhattan. It was buried underneath the rubble. For 2 years, they told me there was no luck. Nothing was salvageable. It was gone. Forget about it. 2 years later, I get a phone call. They said, come ID some boxes. Maybe one's yours. I did. It turns out it was mine.
Unbelievable.
I want to take a look inside here.
Absolutely.
Wow. These are... You know, these are the dollar bills. These are...
Look at that.
You can see they're very fragile. Some of them have been broken already. Just some documents, I guess, I had. And then there's... And this is the one. This is my baby spoon. My mom sent it before she passed away. She sent it on. She said, take care of this. It's a baby spoon. And there's some coins that the heat...
Look at that.
Melted those together and made that one...
And this was 2 years after?
2 years after. So it had been sitting under there, if you remember, that it was still burning for years.
Absolutely.
Afterwards, they were putting water on it. So I assume this is just kind of like it was been underneath the rubble, baking, the heat making it. And you can see the difference in the size. But so it's just my part. I'd just love to donate it to the museum, and hopefully you guys can tell the story.
This is amazing. I mean, I think, you know, artifacts like this that are personal to people make this story real. And for people that are coming from around the world, when they come and they're going to see stuff that they can relate to, like, you know, a baby spoon that someone's mother asked them to take care of, it just brings the whole event absolutely real for people. So this is a truly meaningful donation.
Thank you. I'm proud to be part of it.
Yeah, we really, really appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So you were there in 93 also?
I was in the building when the bombs went off in 93, in the parking garage underneath.
Yeah.
The building shook. It felt like an earthquake. Within minutes, you could smell smoke. And I knew enough to get out of the building. I turned off, and I saw, you know, everything. All the ambulances and fire trucks were lined up on West Street there, and the West Side Highway down there. They were pulling people out, and it was scary. And then I was, like I said, I was right across the river waiting for my boat to come on over on 9/11 that morning. And I watched the second plane fly into the tower. I watched it. I remember smoke first.
Yeah.
And then a massive fireball behind it.
Exactly.
Wow, what is happening? And then, you know, as you recall, the Pentagon, we heard the Pentagon was hit. And it was crazy down here.
Absolutely.
Anyway, thank you very much.
All right, Eric, I really appreciate it. Everyone here does.
Yeah, it's been a very emotional week. That was topped with that. Very emotional for me as well. Artie, you were there. You know people. You have friends who died. I felt really, I'm very proud to be able to do that.
It's great, and it's great what you did, and those of us, you know, I've given money, and I remember being there. And one of the most therapeutic thing was you were able to write out like what your experience was, and you put it in a box, and I believe that's going to be part of the exhibit down there, and that helps everyone. There's so much healing in doing things like that, and I'm sure whenever this is completed, and we wish it would have been completed already, it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful tribute to those who have lost.
The 10th anniversary, September 11th, 11. They're going to open up that big memorial park, and then a year later, this museum is going to open up. Mimi, I was emotional. I'm not saying goodbye yet, but I was emotional.
It's tough. You know, your baby spoon, I mean, for heaven's sakes.
Yeah.
I mean, that gives us all chills.
Ronnie, any final words on it?
Yeah, I mean, I had a lot of friends who were there, and I had three who died, and I don't talk about it very much. I really just don't.
And Mark, what was it like in Washington at the time?
I was in the Rayburn House office building, actually, and people were watching it on TV, and then we heard that the Pentagon had been hit, and you didn't know what was going to happen. And in fact, a lot of people just sort of ran and left the building. There was no warning, nothing. I actually got stuck in a tunnel because all the bridges were closed.
I think we all would agree, if there was something there now, their whole conversations that we've had about this mosque or whatever you want to call it would be very different if,
you know,
by now, 9 years later.
Everyone remembers exactly where they were and what they were doing when those planes hit the towers. Let me read this real quick. Geraldo just sent this to me. He said, I just spoke to Trump. He called Geraldo. He said, quoting Trump, after being extremely critical of the insensitivity of the decision to build
a mosque at the Park Place site. He goes on to say that if the developer would accept a reasonable profit on his investment, he agreed to go east of Broadway. He would be doing himself and the rest of us a big favor. Good point, Artie. Do us all a favor. Just move the thing. Take a reasonable profit.
And that's for Mr. Sensitivity himself, Donald Trump.
And you don't get
warmer and fuzzier than that.
There are a lot of people who are hurt, and I think it would elevate the Muslim people in our community.
The relationships between moderate Muslims in America. We got to leave it there. Artie Idala, Mark Levine, Mimi Roth, and Ron Kuby. Thank you guys very much. We'll see you guys Monday.